Christmas comes but once a year. But for one man...
Ah! Humbug.
That's once too often.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Armchair Directors. I am Crandall.
I'm Mercy. And we're going to take a look at Robert Zemeckis' newest Deadeye opus, the CGI Christmas Carol starring Jim Carrey.
Now, this is labeled as Disney's A Christmas Carol, but fair warning, this movie is terrifying.
Yeah, it is very dark. It is Christmas movies usually give you a nice, warm, fuzzy feeling of hope, joyousness. You know, the original Christmas Carol, the live-action one, the Mickey Mouse one, even the Bill Murray Scrooged one, all of those have their dark parts, but in the end, they have this overwhelming feeling of redemption and warmth, and the character has gone through this miraculous transformation.
Right.
Not so much this time.
Yeah, less and less does Ebenezer Scrooge really become warm-hearted and caring at the end, because even when he does, it feels put on because he just looks so creepy, and the CGI doesn't have that warmth and heart that comes through in a performance of a real person, like, you know, Michael Caine in The Muppet Christmas Carol, which is probably my favorite telling of the story, where you can see him as he's gradually realizing his mistakes, and in the CGI format, we get some very impressive animation, but it's never fully realized as a flesh and blood character who's going on this arc, which is integral to this story being heartwarming and having a good message, rather than just scaring the Dickens out of you by sticking too closely to the Dickens story.
Yeah, well put. My biggest problem with this movie is that, just like you said, there's so much that gets lost in this whole CGI thing. I don't know what Robert Zemeckis is doing. This is his third CGI movie in a row. Mm-hmm. If you're not familiar with Robert Zemeckis, this is the guy that made Back to the Future, the trilogy. He did Forrest Gump.
And Who Framed Roger Rabbit, classic.
And even like more recently, Castaway. These are all great movies that they have movie magic. Mm-hmm. Robert Zemeckis is one of the few filmmakers that is able to put movie magic on the screen, like Steven Spielberg, like James Cameron.
Yeah.
He's one of the masters, and I don't know what the heck he's doing. Beowulf, CGI movie, and then
Polar Express
was a little bit better, but even that is like, it's got that Deadeye to it, and the whole idea of Tom Hanks doing almost every single role in the entire movie. Mm-hmm. I don't think Tom Hanks has the range to pull that off. I love Tom Hanks, but he's not so good that he can play 50 different characters. Just by the end of that movie, I'm kind of sick of him. Mm-hmm. They try to do the same thing here again. Jim Carrey definitely has more range than Tom Hanks, but he is, in my opinion, horribly miscast as Ebenezer Scrooge in this one. He doesn't do anything funny the whole movie. Like,
barely. There's a couple moments where Carrey gets to shine through, but not as Scrooge.
Not as Scrooge, as a different character. But as Scrooge, he's just creepy and dark. And when he does have his redemption at the end of the movie, I don't buy it. In the other versions of the movie, like Bill Murray's Scrooged, or the Mickey Mouse Christmas Carol, or the Muppets one, when the transformation happens, there's a real feeling of redemption and joyousness and, wow, I am lucky to be alive.
Right.
You know, I have learned the error of my ways. In this one, you know what it feels like? It feels like it's a total selfish feeling. Like, I'm alive, and I'm going to do whatever it takes to never go through that again.
To not go through that again for me.
It's all about
him.
Yeah. So it just lacks soul, and a good Christmas movie needs that soul to make it work.
Now, I think, you know, part of the blame has to go to the character design, because you do see a lot of very good facial expressions on Scrooge.
Yep.
And even, you know, the dead eyes are pretty bad, but there are a few moments where you can kind of see Carrie's eyes coming through, but Scrooge is so ugly.
Yeah.
He's got that hook nose and that strong chin, and he just looks like a creep.
And it's a strange choice because some of the people in this movie are photorealistic.
Mm-hmm.
Like Colin Firth's character
looks like Colin
Firth. Exactly like him. And other characters look very, very human. And then for some reason, they decided to distort Jim Carrey with the long nose and the chin, the ghastly. He looks like one of those spitting image puppets that scared the heck out of me when I was growing up. Like the ones that appear in the Genesis video, Land of Confusion. And then they distorted Gary Oldman as well. I mean, Cratchit is supposed to be one of the most heartwarming characters in the movie.
And he, like you said, thought it was Clint Howard playing Bob Cratchit because he does look like a bit of a creep.
Yeah, and then in another miscasting, I don't know who the kid is that played Tiny Tim, but Tiny Tim is supposed to be the character that really pulls on your heartstrings in this movie. And in all the other incarnations I've seen of the Christmas Carol, you know, he's frail and he has that sweet little innocent voice. In this movie, he's robust. I mean, he's got the cane.
Yeah.
He is disabled physically, but he's robust. He's got this loud voice, and it just doesn't work for this poor little Tiny Tim.
And it's funny because usually in most versions, you know, when you find out the fate of Tiny Tim, it really does get to you.
Oh, yeah.
And the music swells like you're supposed to have that moment, but you don't. And you're just sitting there, and I'm thinking, man, when Kermit's nephew Robin was Tiny Tim and he bought it, I was crying. But in this, you're just looking at your watch.
Yeah, it is. There are a lot of boring parts to this.
And I think the pacing really hurts the movie. It starts very quiet, very slow, and then we sort of ease into the ghost, which is sticking very closely to the source material that, you know, it takes a while before these ghosts show up, which is fine. But for a kids movie, man, kids would be getting restless right off the bat in this thing.
Yeah, for sure. And also, like, the budget of this movie, I thought it was cheap, and that's why Zemeckis is choosing to do all these CGI movies. Not only not having to deal with actors, but sets, and just let's draw everything and animate it. This was a $200 million movie.
Basically, they make the movie twice, because they film it live action with everybody and the motion controls and all that stuff, and then they have to animate it, which is two crews, because you have a film crew, and then you have the special effects crew. So these are a very expensive process when they make these kind of movies.
Yeah, and I can't believe that when it's that expensive, it's so slow and boring. I mean, there are minutes where nothing is happening, and I'm just counting the thousands of dollars, you know, being expended on a doorknob that is ever so slightly turning.
Now, I'll say the only thing that maybe I liked it more than you is because when all these quiet moments are going on, the visuals are very rich.
The animation...
Despite the fact that I think the character designs are you know, the environments and the way everything is photographed is just stunning. Mm-hmm. And especially on Blu-ray or on the 3D Blu-ray version, just amazing to look at and take in the atmosphere. But it really does feel like a ghost story for adults and a ghost story, not a Christmas story that happens to have ghosts. No, this is a ghost story with very terrifying moments about mortality, death, and, you know, really creepy stuff going on.
Yeah, exactly. It looks fantastic, but it's lacking this, which is what Christmas movies need to work.
Absolutely.
So, time for best part.
Worst part.
Best part.
Best part.
Best part.
Best part.
Would have to be the cast.
I gotta go with the tank sequence.
The special effects.
The final 10 minutes of the movie.
Man in suit.
Man in suit! So that's the best part.
Worst part.
Worst part.
Worst part.
Worst part.
Love story with Jessica Biel.
Cheap sounding canned.
Michelle Rodriguez.
Jennifer Aniston.
The entire movie. I will say best part is the action sequences, which are the part where they deviate from the Charles Dickens story the most. You know, when Scrooge fires off like a rocket and is flying over the town and all this kind of stuff.
The obligatory action scene.
Right. And those are the moments that I know a lot of critics were like, oh, they crammed all these action scenes into this movie and it didn't need it. We're just flying all over the place and he's getting hit with icicles. But those moments are loud and fun and they're the only little bits of joy in the movie. When we get the spectacle and all this fast-paced fun, which typically Disney movies like this usually promise.
Yep.
So I enjoyed those moments more than the soft-spoken, quiet ghost story movies. Worst part, the character designs are just creepy. And a few moments were very intensely scary, especially for a Disney movie. Mm-hmm. When he is hanging into his own grave.
Yeah.
And the angel of death is like hovering over him. I'm going to dream about that all week.
Yeah, and then even stranger is the scene immediately after that is he wakes up.
And everything's great.
Yeah, it just does not flow. Mm-hmm. It does not jive. My worst part is a two-parter. First, I'm going to go with the language. They decided to stay very true to the Dickens language, and I wish they hadn't. Really should have been updated.
What hath doth thou mean, sir? Exactly.
So that, I think, really needed an update in language. And some of the characters I couldn't even understand because their English accent was so thick. Like when there's 4 minutes going by and I can't understand a word being said, there's a serious problem. And then the other part of my worst part is the serious miscastings. Jim Carrey is a fantastic actor, but he's you know, comedic. He's funny, and he doesn't do anything funny in this movie. Waste of Jim Carrey. Gary Oldman is a great actor, but again, not the right guy to play Cratchit. Gary Oldman has a commanding voice. He's got a very commanding presence. The guy was Dracula. The guy was Sirius Black. He was, even Commissioner Gordon kind of grows that confidence. Not the right guy for Cratchit. And then a number of other characters too. Just miscastings all across the board. The Tiny Tim I mentioned earlier. Best part is the one part Jim Carrey actually does get to show his playful, mischievous side when Carrey, who pulls double, triple, maybe quadruple duty in this movie, plays the ghost of Christmas past, a flame, a candle. And you get to see that mischievousness and very strange kind of charismatic, enigmatic kind of twitches and ticks and just the playfulness in the face, you know. Very reminiscent of Crispin Glover, I thought, in Back to the Future.
Basically, if you're looking for a heartwarming Christmas movie,
watch Elf.
This is not it. You know, if you do want to see some cool animation, there's definitely enough here that if you're a fan of animation or this whole process, that I think it's worth seeing, especially the mode where you can actually just see them filming it as the actors to see how they make these movies.
Yeah, that footage, though, is a little bit heartbreaking because the acting talent that Jim Carrey shows in those motion capture scenes where he's got all the dots on his face and all the stuff hooked up to him. If this had been a live action movie, I swear he would have won an Oscar for this because he just had so much soul in his eyes. His eyes are watering up and all of that got lost in the translation into CGI. It's just really sad to see how much effort the guy put into it. And the guy is a great dramatic actor. And maybe he could have pulled it off if it was real. But in CGI, I was expecting something a little more comedic. You know, because it's more of like, even though The Grinch was live action, The Grinch was closer to something like this. It's that kind of fantastical world. And I just feel like I was a little bit misled when I saw The Christmas Carol starring Jim Carrey. I mean, it's a Christmas movie with Jim Carrey.
Yeah. Hopefully Robert Zemeckis will go to live action for his next movie because he is one of my favorite directors and these movies have not been any of my favorite movies.
Yeah, me neither. So, yeah, hopefully he will return to form, maybe with Forrest Gump 2 or Back to the Future 4.
Either of those would be terrible. And hopefully they would be better than this one.
Well, I think so, yeah. All right, so thanks a lot for watching. Until next time.
Enjoy the show.
Since I first met your face, yeah. Well, I'm talking about people getting inside your mind. And where had I feel this way? Say goodbye to the